So many studies say that coffee is hurting you or coffee is helping you. Everyone wants something out of coffee, but all it wants to do is give. Howdy, hot brown water hawkers. Trace here for DNews. Scientists have again and again and again tried to find out what coffee is doing to the human body. A study in Scientific Reports lays it out nicely, saying, coffee consumption has been linked to protective effects on various common pathologies, such as cardiovascular diseases, hypertension, Alzheimer's and Parkinson's diseases, type 2 diabetes, some types of cancer, and hearing functions, and may predispose to others, such as sleep disturbance. Whew. Scientists have been studying coffee since the 1960s, and a 1972 study in Cell's Biophysical Journal tried to find out exactly what it was doing to our cells, noting caffeine binds to broken DNA and that if it's present during the formation of new DNA, it can cause breaks in chromosomes, which is why we've long known pregnant humans probably shouldn't consume it. We've also found that when DNA is broken by other processes, caffeine can play with those broken pieces, keeping them DNA broke. But confusingly, a study in March 2016's Molecular Nutrition and Food Research found coffee drinking reduced DNA breakage by about a third, and that reduction continued for hours. So coffee, or caffeine really, can break DNA or keep it from being broken depending on when the coffee hits your DNA. It's important to note, DNA breakage is not necessarily a bad thing. Normal cell functions can break it, but so can UV light, certain chemicals, and irradiation. More research be needed. In the decades since we started looking into coffee and caffeine, study after study keeps coming out talking about DNA. For example, a study in the European Journal of Nutrition found spontaneous DNA strand breaks were somewhat less likely in those who drank dark roast coffee. A 2012 study in Cell Metabolism found the DNA of people who exercised had fewer methyl groups, a specific type of chemical marker that occurs when DNA goes through a chemical change. Caffeine mimics that methylation. This shows both exercise and coffee affect DNA pretty dynamically. Another pair of studies, one with Italians who do love their cafe, and another in the Netherlands, the Dutch drink 2.6 times more coffee than Americans, found that people who drink coffee pass their habit to their offspring, pinpointing several genes associated with coffee drinking, which is interesting because a study in Scientific Reports found a mutation on gene PDSS2, which is associated with drinking fewer cups of coffee. In a twin study, using both identical and fraternal twins, the identicals had higher correlations of habits like smoking, coffee drinking, and alcohol consumption, indicating to the researchers that there was a genetic component. But it's not just genetics. You can change your DNA with your behaviors in life. This is called epigenetics. A study in biochemistry found mice that were chronic overeaters passed genetic markers to their offspring, and then they had higher levels of insulin resistance, so they were more likely to be diabetic. Could this happen with coffee too? Again, more research is needed. In my opinion, a lot of these studies have more to do with our love of coffee than the magical powers of this beverage we happen to drink. Coffee drinking is really common. According to the International Coffee Organization, over 9 billion kilograms of coffee were consumed in 2015 and 16. Most of the countries on our planet consume coffee. It's one of the most consumed beverages anywhere. Tea is tops, of course. And it's one of humanity's primary sources of the drug caffeine. And yet, it's super interesting that we still don't know a lot about the epigenetics of coffee. And remember, it's not just about coffee. All DNA is constantly affected by the food you eat. DNA is created, copied, and created throughout your life, so you are literally what you eat. So next time you're having a Java, think about your kids, because what's happening to them? Who knows? More research is needed, and science is awesome, and also, I need a coffee. Sorry, unborn kid. When you don't get your coffee, are you a monster? Is there a monster inside of you? You should watch the show of that same name on Animal Planet Go. Seriously, it's about parasites and worms, and then it's amazing. They also have cheesy computer animation. You're gonna like it. Download the Animal Planet Go app from the App Store or use the link in the description to watch that and all the past episodes of your favorite Animal Planet shows. Are you drinking too much caffeine? Do you know the medical limit? Find out in this video. Oh my God, it's such an old video. Look at my hair, it's so weird. Do you have a favorite coffee? Tell us, because I want it. Go down into the comments, let us know. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews. And thanks for watching.